Our second speaker of this session is Mr. Sanjay Singhal, founder and principal consultant Strategizers, an electrical engineering graduate from IIT Roorkee. Mr. Singhal previously worked as MD at Accenture and led the delivery of complete technology services for BPO business. Mr. Singhal is a perfect blend of business strategy, operations, techno-commercial and academic elegance. He has authored a book titled Software Project Management on managing software projects more efficiently. He is the mentor of several startups and serves on their board. I request Mr. Sanjay Singhal on the podium to come on the podium for his deliberations. Sir, please.
Good afternoon, guys. So first of all, I thank Professor Singh for having me here. It's been a pleasure to be amongst you. Yes. Slide some more, please. जब मैं बोलूँगा तभी क्लिक करेंगे. Now before I start, a few show of hands. So get ready. Show of hands, please. How many of you are undergraduate students? And how many of you are MBA or PGDM students? What is it? Undergrad? Undergrad first? Undergrad. Keep your hands raised prominently. Undergrad. BBA. All right. Anybody else is postgraduate? Yes, no? All right, excellent. How many of you have you heard of entrepreneurship? Louder. How many of you plan to start a venture of your own? How many of you plan to start a venture of your own after completing your education? Why are you sitting back? If you're really keen on starting your venture, come to the front. Who else? आप कोई नहीं कर रहा था? मैं उतर आ जाऊंगा. चलाएं? Come to the front, have a front seat. Now I'm not going to talk anything that is taught to you here on a day-to-day basis. So I will not talk of theory. That's a given. Okay? But you have to give me a promise. Which means you will interact with me. You will ask me questions or answer my questions. Is that a fair thing? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Louder.
Yes, sir.
All right. I'll move. So I have picked up a topic which has three things included in it. One is entrepreneurial skills. The second is opportunity. And the third one is, what does a strategy contribute to the entrepreneurship? Sounds fair? Do you think these things are important? Yes, no?
Yes.
You're violating my rule. One. And then I will use rule three, which means I will take this session for 2 hours. इसलिए आप लोग आंसर करिए ठीक है. All right. So तीन चीजों की मैं बात करूंगा लेकिन मैं थ्योरी की बात नहीं करूंगा. Next slide, please. Yes. So just for the sake of putting in the context, here are the definition of entrepreneurship and here is the definition of a startup. The keywords, I have highlighted them. What are the keywords here? The development and ground up. Which means you're not going to take on a venture, take on a organization which already exists. You will start afresh. Right? What's the other thing? Idea and turning it into a profitable business. I'll give you an example of an idea. I came across this about 3 weeks back. And this this is actually live example. I don't know how many of you are familiar with the medical scheme of things, but you know, if you get your urine and blood tested in a lab, there is something called routine examination and there is something called culture examination. Suna hai? Jor se. Culture mein kitna time lagta hai usually? Culture examination mein usually, if it is urine, it takes about 48 hours. And if it is blood, it takes about 72 hours. Okay. I met somebody who has done a research project which can cut down the duration of the culture test significantly. Culture test significantly. Uska benefit kya hoga? Agar aapko culture ki report jaldi mil jayegi, to culture ki report pe basis pe kya hota hai ki doctor advise karta hai, kaun sa antibiotic lena chahiye. Right? और जब तक कल्चर रिपोर्ट आती है उसके बीच में डॉक्टर बोलता है कि मेरे अंदाजे से आप ये एंटीबायोटिक लेना शुरू कर दो. भगवान की मर्जी है, अगर आपके काम आ गया तो, नहीं काम आया तो भी ठीक है, फिर जब तक कल्चर की रिपोर्ट आएगी उसके बाद अगला दे देंगे. ठीक है, ये होता है. तो वो दो दिन बाद होगा इन द केस ऑफ यूरिन 48 घंटे, और तीन दिन बाद होगा इन द केस ऑफ ब्लड. जब कल्चर की रिपोर्ट आएगी तो मैं एक्यूरेट एंटीबायोटिक आपको दूंगा, तब तक आप बीमार रहिए. ठीक है, अगर मैं इसको कट डाउन करके 4 घंटे कर दूं टाइम, विच मीन्स आपने सैंपल दिया 12 बजे, शाम को 4 बजे कल्चर की रिपोर्ट ले लीजिए, तो मैं शाम से आपका एक्यूरेट एंटीबायोटिक शुरू कर सकता हूं. राइट, पॉसिबल है ना? तो आप जल्दी ठीक हो जाओगे. दूसरा बात क्या होगा कि आपका एंटीबायोटिक्स एब्यूज नहीं होगा, क्योंकि एंटीबायोटिक्स एब्यूज से क्या होता है एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंस हो जाती है, कि धीरे धीरे वो एंटीबायोटिक्स आप पे काम करना बंद कर देते हैं. राइट, नाउ व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ स्टार्टअप, ग्राउंड्स अप डेवलपमेंट इनिशिएटिव. व्हाट इज इट? द पर्सन हु इज डूइंग दिस फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, इज नॉट बीन डन एनीवेयर एल्स. राइट, दिस इन टुडेज जार्गन दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ डिसरप्टिव फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस, विच इज वॉट एवर बिजनेस एग्जिस्ट राइट नाउ, यू डिसरप्टिंग दिस. राइट, suppose you open a lab tomorrow which says I'm going to give a culture report in 4 hours, aapke samne ek aur khuli hai bolta hai main culture report dunga 48 ghante mein, naturally log aapke paas aayenge. Right, uski to dukaan band ho jayegi, isn't it? What are you doing? You're disrupting the existing business. Right, so entrepreneurship, startups is all about disrupting whatever is happening right now. Next one. Okay, and the purpose of a startup is to create a repeatable and a scalable business model, right? Which means आप उसको बार बार कर सको. तो 4 घंटे, यानी कि मैंने एक रिपोर्ट 4 घंटे में जनरेट कर दी, आई शुड बी एबल टू जनरेट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ रिपोर्ट्स एवरी रिपोर्ट इन 4 आवर्स टाइम. ओके, एंड आई शुड बी एबल टू स्केल दिस. राइट, लाल पैथ लैब्स विच नाउ एग्जिस्ट एवरीवेयर, सम ईयर्स बैक वॉज द ओनली लैब इन डेली, एट प्लेस इन डेली ऑल्सो. राइट, सो it's now converted its business into a scalable business, repeatable business. Right, so that's the purpose of a startup, and I'll stop with the theory here, no more theory. Next one please. Now opportunity landscape. So what kind of an opportunity exists for the entrepreneurship, for those of you who are particularly interested in starting a venture? State of economy. Our economy mein teen cheeze hain, manufacturing, services and agriculture. Okay, teen hi cheeze hain bas, और कुछ नहीं है. सो इफ यू लुक एट दिस ग्राफ यू विल सी दैट ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम सर्विसेज पोर्शन ऑफ द इकोनॉमी हैज बीन ग्रोइंग, एग्रीकल्चर पोर्शन ऑफ द इकोनॉमी इज बाय एंड लार्ज स्टेबल, सॉरी एग्रीकल्चर पोर्शन ऑफ द इकोनॉमी हैज बीन बाय एंड लार्ज फॉलिंग, एंड द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग पोर्शन ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री इज बाय एंड लार्ज स्टेबल. नाउ व्हाट डज दिस मीन? व्हाट दिस मीन्स इज, सॉरी, yeah, what this, right, don't need a point, wo cut raha hai वैसे वहीं पे, इसको मेरी तरफ घुमा दो लैपटॉप को यार, मैं कम से कम पढ़ सकूं. What this means is that services economy, and the fourth thing which is missing here is the internet. So you see one of the information there which says internet economy expected to be about $200 billion by 2018. Okay, what this means is that the services and the internet economy will drive the growth of the business. And you would see this around. You see lot more construction happening. Now the construction is a services industry, lot more financial services happening, right? How many of you use Paytm? All right, pretty good. How many of you buy on Flipkart? Excellent. So that's all that is internet based services economy, right? Now what is making all this possible? Now I know 10 years back or maybe 14 years back all of you were kids. So this is probably a question for some of the senior people in the room here. But you know there was a dot-com boom in 99-2000. Suna hai aap logon ne? Suna hai? 2001 mein uske baad kya hua tha? Bust. Kyun hua tha? Ki pata kisi ko? और उस टाइम के बूम और आज के बूम में क्या डिफरेंस है? सॉरी, टेक्नोलॉजी हैज हायर. ओके, व्हाट एल्स? स्मार्टफोन्स, इंटरनेट एक्सेस. मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल वर नॉट अवेयर. सो या is it I can roam around? Yes. Lack of awareness. Sorry, lack of skills to use. Okay, what else? Aapko pata kitne mobile phones hai India mein? How many mobile phones exist in the country? How many mobile phones exist in the country? Crores. How many people use mobile phones? How many mobile phone users are there? Okay. India ki? What? Mobile phones kitne hai? Jor se bolo yaar. 50 crore. 1.5 crore. Banaras mein honge yaar. 120 crores. You're pretty close. You're not far off. Nahi utne bhi nahi hai. All right. The number of mobile phones in the country is about 100 crores. 100 crores. 120 crore ke Hindustan mein 100 crore mobile phone hai aur log kehte hain hum poor country hai. Are we? No. Okay, so here is a certification from here onwards. India is not a poor country. Right? All right, so one thing is very clear. Technology has changed very, very quickly over the years and has made things possible. The difference, primary difference in 2001 and in 2015, into the boom in the internet is that 2015 boom is driven by consumer demand. It's driven by consumer demand. Whereas 2001 was thrust upon people. In 2001, the highest possible speed people had access to was about 64K, which is probably less than the 2G speed that you get on your mobile phones today, right? The multimedia content wasn't really possible. Most people depended on the ad revenue to generate revenue from their internet businesses. That's a change which has happened over a period of time in the technology. And that change has thrown open several opportunities for a lot of people. And I'm sure many of you, while today you're not saying or you're hesitating in saying that you would be an entrepreneur, I'm sure some of you or many of you will be an entrepreneur in future. Next slide, please. Next. Okay, look at the startup scenario. At this point of time, Delhi and Bangalore have the largest number of startups in the country. But there's no reason why it should remain that way. Okay? And there's an expectation that in the next 5-6 years, India will become a major startup hub. And remember the definition of startup, the creative business, not doing something that is already existing, right? Creating something new and starting a business on its own. Remember Flipkart 5 years back. What was the first thing Flipkart started to sell? Books. Why? And because Amazon was selling books, it was selling several other things that time also. But why Flipkart started with only books? Think about that. I can answer this, but I will not answer it. Keep thinking about it. All right, next. Now, there are a lot of people who are ready to put money in companies. Okay, yesterday morning I was reading something which says the Snap deal. How many of you buy from Snap deal? That company which started about 2 or 3 years back, 2 se 3 saal pehle kisi ne naam suna Snap deal ka? Nahi suna tha na? That company today is worth $7 billion. Can you imagine the CEO and COO of that company? वो क्या बोलते हैं, वारे न्यारे हो गए उनके, है ना? ठीक कह रहा हूं मैं? Right? So that's the power of entrepreneurship. That's the power of startup. When you do something disruptive. No. So Amazon existed outside India. It's only when Flipkart, it can be in several different ways. Okay? Yes. Yeah. So I won't call Snapdeal as a strict startup, but Flipkart was from an India perspective. Okay? A lot more people today are ready to put money on startups and help and have you run business or set up business on their money. Okay, move on. Yeah. Take a look at these. Flipkart, Myntra, Yapmi, Car Dekho, Car Wale, Chaios, naam sune? Are these successful? No? Most of them? Which one isn't? Meru, Ola, Make My Trip. Are these successful? Why? Why are they successful? Why are they successful? This is the crux of a successful startup business.
Because they are adopting new technique.
Okay, what else? Yeah. Unique, what else? Chai bech raha hai yaar, Chaios. Usme unique kya hai? Chaios is chai. And he's an IIT graduate. Okay. What else? Innovative strategy. Save time. So what is the bottom line here? What is the bottom line here? Next slide, please. The bottom line is every business either solves a problem or fulfills a need. Right? Agreed? If you're neither solving a problem or fulfilling a need, your shop will shut down in 24 hours. Right? How successful you will be is dependent upon how prevalent the problem is or how painful the need is. The need could be either a latent or an active need. Right? So each of these guys, can you put slide back? Slide back. Each of these guys are either fulfilling a need or solving a problem, right? Next. Now, to be able to create a successful business, first and foremost, now there are I will talk about three broad categories. Now this is my last slide. After this, there's no more slide. So first and foremost, build the right product. Okay? Now how would you build the right product? Next slide. You have to understand your customer first. Right? So what did Flipkart do which was right? At the time of Flipkart was the only... No, don't go. Up. Obviously. जब Flipkart शुरू हुआ था उस समय there were a lot of people in India who were scared of providing their credit card numbers on internet, right? Because they thought the fraudulent transactions can happen, right? So what did Flipkart do? It started with cash on delivery, right? What else? People were not used to buying on internet. What did they start with? Book, which is very, very standard. आपको कपड़ा खरीदना है तो आप सोचोगे यार ये मैं कपड़ा देख के पता करूंगा कैसा है, तो किताब में क्या है, राइट? नथिंग विल चेंज. तो व्हाट वाज दैट? दे वर क्रिएटिंग अ बायर बाइंग बिहेवियर, दे वर बिल्डिंग देयर कंज्यूमर्स, राइट? सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड योर कस्टमर फर्स्ट. दैट इज द फर्स्ट एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट लेसन ऑफ एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. नेक्स्ट वन प्लीज. द नेक्स्ट इज अंडरस्टैंड द कॉम्पिटिशन. अंडरस्टैंड who exists as your competition today, what is it that they do right now, and what is it that you're going to do differently, right? To be successful, there is no point in saying I will also do what 10 others are doing. That's waste, right? Next slide please. Third one is identify your differentiators. How will you differentiate from your competition? Sorry? Who is more successful? Who is more successful? How many of you use Google as your search engine? How many of you use Bing as your search engine? No one. No one, really. Just one person. Right. Yeah, so the point is Google was the first one which started with this concept called search engine. Right? So, Google was the, understand the customer. They understood the customer requirement that you need something to search on internet. Right? Now, everything else that is coming up is either trying to outpace Google in some way or the other. Now, whether it was Yahoo, Bing, or anything else. Right? Because Amazon wasn't as that active in India. Not so active, right? Now what is happening? Then once the buyer behavior got established, now Flipkart has to do newer things, right? Ek meri puri baat sun lo pehle. So now Flipkart has to do newer things, right? Flipkart hai, competition is Snapdeal. Amazon bhi hai. Some people say eBay also is there, right? Halanki eBay ka market share abhi kafi kam ho gaya hai. Now, four of these are competitors. Now, if you have to retain your customer, and internet is a ruthless marketplace, right? If you don't like a site, you will unlikely visit it second time, right? So, Flipkart has to do something new. So, what they've done, they started to have exclusive arrangements with sellers, right? So, Motorola sells only on Flipkart, Motorola phones. Lenovo phones sell exclusively only on Flipkart. That became their differentiator. Now Snapdeal started to copy the same strategy of Flipkart. They're coming up with similar exclusive arrangements, right? So the point here is that one, you need to understand what your customer wants. You need to understand what are the strengths and weaknesses of your competition, and you need to figure out how will you going to differentiate yourself and continue to differentiate yourself. Now, so first piece that I had was build the product. The second piece, click again, is building the organization. So my strategy is built around three building blocks. Build the product, build the organization, and the third one is operate with efficiency. Okay? So the second one, which is build the organization, is establish a corporate philosophy. Now, a lot of people call this, divide this corporate philosophy into values, vision, etc., etc. Vision, mission, values, right? What do they help? They help you to communicate what do you stand for. Okay, I will not go into the details of that, but that's part and parcel of building the organization. Second one is branding and tagline. Right? How many of you can tell me what is the tagline for Nike? Just do it. Yeah. So if you see just do it anywhere, what comes to your mind? Nike. So branding and tagline go hand in hand because they generate the recall value, right? If you see a Flipkart logo somewhere, you would immediately imagine the Flipkart to be the Flipkart.com, right? Similarly, if you see an A, you will know it is an Amazon. Or you see an apple with one bite taken, you would say it's an Apple product. Very clearly, right? So the logos, the taglines help generate a brand recall, right? And brand recall brings brand loyalty. Brand loyalty brings more customers. Next one. Build the right team. Now it is very clear in a startup mode particularly that you will not be able to do everything on your own, right? You cannot be an expert. You will always need a team. Now, the mistake that most startups make in India is they have a homogeneous team. Yaar, hum dono saath padhte the, teri meri achhi dosti hai, chal ek startup shuru karte hain. Both of you know the same thing. Nobody knows finance in your team, right? Nobody knows sales and marketing because that's something that you guys have not done. So try and build a heterogeneous team, right? If you can't build a heterogeneous team, get your advisors, mentors, right? It's all about building the right team. Next one. Now again, the things that you can't do, establish alliances and partners. Now this could be supply chain, right? Because everything you may not be making, manufacturing yourself. Next one, operate with efficiency. I have three parameters to this. One is, next one please. Have a customer culture. Remember what happened to Snapdeal when they first started? How many of you actually experienced it? I don't know. But at least in the Delhi area, it is very commonly said that when Snapdeal first started, one, they had a poor website. Their website used to crash. And secondly, their shipments were wrong. So you ordered for something, they sent you something. It was either the wrong product shipped or a faulty product shipped or a poor product shipped. And once you get that from an e-commerce company, you're assured that you will not go and buy again, right? Now, they're putting in a lot of effort to revive their brand image in the market. Everybody would say Flipkart is more reliable, right? When Amazon came in and said Amazon delivered, right? Have you seen Amazon delivered? And you feel more assured when something is Amazon delivered. Similarly, when you say Flipkart and say e-car delivered, you feel more assured. One, faster delivery, quicker delivery, you'll get the product much better, right? So all these are customer culture where you are more customer oriented. You're serving the customer. Next one, which relates to the Gandhiji's statement, it says we exist because of our customers. Customer doesn't exist because of us. Yeah. The second one is innovation at the core, which is irrespective of what you've reached, you still need to continue to innovate. Right? Keep innovating, keep evolving. Otherwise, your competition will catch up, they'll probably move ahead of you. And then last one is run an efficient business, which means you may need a dashboard. That's when you start to become a slightly larger company because now you can't oversee everything. You need a dashboard, measurement parameters, track them regularly, etc., etc. So that's my 10 commandments for the startups, 10 basic building blocks for any business strategy. Okay? Move to the next one. Open for questions, if any. Questions, guys? Guys and girls? Yeah.
You're talking about the startups, and that was a great speech. I wonder most about that 8 out of the 10 companies that get established.
Sorry?
8 out of the 10 companies, I mean startups, they get destroyed within the 3 years of time. So I think that is more important than establishing the company itself. Would you put some light on that?
Yeah, so the next speaker that you have,
okay,
he's an entrepreneur himself. All right, and he'll be better positioned to answer your question. But the fact of the matter is that today there is a rat race of startups. Everybody is sort of starting things. And starting things in a very similar area, right? Now when you get into a similar area, you usually, you know, one, you create a lot of confusion amongst your customers. You create a lot of confusion amongst your investors as well. And no investor is very, very convinced to say, you know, if there are 10 companies of that kind,
what would be the scalability of this company that is now coming up, right? So it's unlikely to put money on you. Now, if you don't get money, how would you run the business, right? How would you survive, or how long will you survive? So that becomes the bit of a challenge. And that is where the, if you go back, the first three building blocks of my strategy, which is understand your customer, his or her needs, what do they want, identify your competition, identify your differentiators, becomes extremely important for you. So my message here is that if you are serious about a startup, don't get into this Me Too race. Now, everybody is starting a cab service, so let me start a cab service also, right? What is it that will be different for you, which is going to be different from Meru, Ola, or whatever else, or Uber? If it is not, why should somebody put money on you? Why would customer now buy from you because suddenly you are the new one in the market, right? So all those challenges come in. So avoid this Me Too syndrome. I call this as Me Too syndrome. Avoid that. Any other question? Yes, please. How much more time do I have? Time is over? 2 to 3 minutes. So maybe last question.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Arpit Shivastav. My question is that if I want to buy something from Flipkart and the same model is also on Snapdeal, but the price money of both the things are different on both the sites.
Yep.
After 24 hours, the price get also either it sometimes it get hikes on or it get loses.
Yes.
So is there the market strategy is the basic fundamental thing behind that, or is there anything? So how a customer get trusted that we will trust a leading brand, or we will select a price less price brand?
Use Zenly.com. So is that right? You can use Zenly.com to figure out the lowest price. So what is that? That's on the lighter vein that you could use Zenly.com, but obviously it's part of their business strategy. And let's be very clear, the price is a factor of demand and supply. Right?
Yes.
So that's where it is.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Thank you very much. If there are more questions, you guys can come and talk to me later.